As content creators, how we do things is changing faster than it ever has before. From how we come up with video ideas, to how we write scripts, to how we edit videos, and now, how we make thumbnails is changing forever. And the best part is, this change that just happened in how we make thumbnails is completely free for you to do. And I'm not hyping this up, I have to show this to you. The tool is called Nano Banana, and it's from Google, and I'm gonna show you how you can apply it to your thumbnails. And we're starting right now. So the first thing we want to do is we want to go to Google AI Studio, then we want to click on Try Nano Banana. Next, I'm going to grab one of my thumbnail images, and I'm just going to paste it into here. Now, one thing that I've learned so far when using this is that whatever image that you upload into it, it's going to maintain that aspect ratio, it seems. So if I upload a 16:9 image like this, then it's going to maintain that aspect ratio. If I do a 9:16 vertical, then it's going to maintain that aspect ratio. And the same thing applies when you're loading images into it to combine together. But let's see what we can do. Generate an image of this guy sitting in a coffee shop wearing a black button-up dress shirt. The coffee shop in the background should be modern and hip. Let's see how it interprets that. He should be holding a to-go cup of coffee. And I'm gonna come up here and make a small modification to the coffee shop. I'm gonna add that it should have a relaxing ambience. And instead of the coffee cup, he should be working on a MacBook Pro sitting in front of him. He should be viewed from the front like the viewer standing in front of him. And the image should look cinematic and moody. Let's hit run right down here and see what happens. Wow. Remove the coffee mug and have him looking at the camera / viewer. Remove the laptop from the table in the background with the two people. Now, I'm not sure if this is going to be specific enough, but we're going to see. It might remove this one. Huh, it got it. Look at that. So if we zoom in, now it's just two people hanging out back there. I guess they're both looking at a coffee cup. So we're just going to remove them entirely. Remove the people from the background. Yeah. Much better. And look how just moody and all of that that this looks. Like, this is pretty incredible. So now, instead of a black shirt, put him in a gray hoodie.
As you can see here, it created the image, it changed the environment that we were in based on our instructions, and all we started with was the basic headshot. Now, before I show you another example, I do want to let you know that you can add text with this, but right now, if you drop it into Photoshop, TubeSpanner, Canva, or another thumbnail tool, you can add text to make a thumbnail that would have required a photo shoot in a matter of minutes without leaving your house. Now, let's do another example with just a screenshot from a video.
Generate an image of this guy in a busy subway station waiting for a train. Make the image cinematic and moody and make sure the guy is close up. He should still be looking at the camera and he should be wearing a red hoodie. Make the entire scene look realistic. Yeah, this one actually turned out fantastic. Okay, so that turned out really good. I'm happy with that. So now, remove the people from the background. So here, just to change the environment and see what we can do, I'm saying instead of a subway, make him standing in a recording studio. Remove the mic stand and headphones. Make the entire scene a little more moody. Change his hoodie to black instead of red. Okay, so we're getting there. And we can see after all of these generations, you know, the eyes are changing, you know, just a little bit, but it's still holding the general look together, but it's definitely making some modifications here to the eyes. And just to see how it does with text generation, I'm saying put the word Niminati on the wall behind him above the window that's behind him. So I'm telling it where to actually place it to see if it'll do it. Okay, now let's see what we can do with this. Change the Niminati word to a red neon light and make the rest of the room look like it has some glow from the red light. Also, make the guy look backlit from the red light. All right, so that looks a little bit hokey. We've officially gotten off the rails, so we might as well keep going. Give the guy sunglasses, change the text in the background to Niminati Studios. With this update with the Niminati Studios, I think that actually looks really cool back there. It definitely looks fake, but I think it did a good job in terms of the text itself and the positioning of the text. I was thinking that it was going to put the Niminati on one side and the studios next to it, so it's all horizontal, but I love how it just took the initiative to stack it like that. Okay, so for fun, we're going to put an 80s style thick gold rope chain around the guy's neck so he looks like a rapper from the 80s. Okay, he's starting to look more separate from the background. Not a huge fan of that part. Let's see if we can make it blend. So now I told it, instead of white lights in the ceiling, make them blue with a blue cast, put a treatment over the entire image so everything blends together more naturally and looks realistic. So I guess is like once you have it match all the colors, then because you can see it's added some blue, you know, over here, a little bit of blue cast over there. So all of that is fantastic. Next, we're going to change the white ceiling to dark wood panels with leading lines so they point towards the neon sign. Let's see if it can do that. Oh, nice. That turned out really cool.
As you can see in this example, before we move on, you can literally put yourself into any scenario that you want. And if you combine this with Google's VO3, you can also take this image that's just incredible and you can drop this into VO3 and you can turn it into a piece of video content that you can also use for B-roll if you want as well. Or you can use the image just by itself and add a little bit of a pan or a little bit of a zoom. That's called the Ken Burns effect. And it's a great way to get the B-roll shots that you need in a pinch. Or you can also use it to modify images that you already have, like in this example.
Let's say that you make a thumbnail and as part of your thumbnail design plan, you're gonna use certain colors and it would just look better if you were wearing a different colored shirt. You can tell it to change the t-shirt to whatever color you want. And within seconds, we have a different realistic looking t-shirt color.
So I've been using Photoshop since it first came out, and to make that change of the color on the shirt, that would have taken me at least 5 to 10 minutes to get everything perfect and balanced and looking right. But now with this, regardless of your skill level, regardless of your understanding of Photoshop, you can get really high quality changes to the things that you need to make the image exactly as you want it for the thumbnails or the B-roll images that you're putting together.
Another thing you can do is, depending on the type of thumbnails you make, if you're like, hey, I would really like to use this image again, but I screwed it up because I didn't save the image and I just have the text on there. In that case, I'm gonna tell it to remove the YouTube logo and text from this image. And bam, it removed the YouTube logo and the text. It left this little line here that was included in the previous version as well. And it's pretty incredible that it was able to remove the text on that and still maintain this actual line there. Pretty amazing. Another use case for this is if you wanted to A/B test thumbnail colors using YouTube's A/B testing feature. You can simply load up the thumbnail. I'm gonna tell it to change the yellow in this image to light blue and change the shirt color on the guy to a color that's complementary to the background. And just like that, we've changed the colors, and I'm gonna tell it to make the background blue darker, but make sure it's still complementary to the orange shirt. So as you can see, we can keep iterating on this until we get what we want. So let's say you're making a video and you have some friends in the video, so you have the screenshot, but you didn't take the right pictures in the right places that you need. One thing that you can do is, like in this scenario, I say generate an image of these four guys taking a selfie in front of the DMZ in North Korea. So it did that and it put them there, but it looks a little bit wonky. So here I told it to add a color grade to the entire image to make it look realistic, like they're really there. So in this situation, we went from this to this, all in just a few prompts. Again, this tool is called Nano Banana, and you can use it for free right now inside of Google's AI Studio.
And to see more videos of AI tools that can help you in other ways, click into this playlist right here, and I'll see you in one of the other videos. Thanks for watching.